What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to tweak your CPUs to get, you know, nice performance and efficiency out of them when it comes to crypto mining. It does work for gaming as well if that's something you want to do, but in this case we're going to be making these efficient CPU miners. All right, for display purposes I am using a Ryzen 9 9950 X3D, and the motherboard is a Gigabyte X870 Ice. Now this will work, the steps and everything will be exactly the same for both AM4 and AM5. That is your 3000 series, 5000 series, 7000 series, and 9000 series. The only difference is AM5 will have a high bandwidth mode for the memory, which we'll show you and kind of explain that later on. But right now, let's jump into this and show you how to tweak your CPUs. All right, so before you get started inside of your motherboard, you're gonna wanna Google the CPU you have if you don't know the base clock speed. So for an example, here's the 9950 X3D, and we can see our base clock is 4.3 gigahertz. Now, if I come in to say a 3900X, we'll Google that, the base clock is 3.8 gigahertz. So we're gonna be running our base clocks when we do our overclock settings and undervolts and stuff. And this is the default that we're gonna run depending on the CPU that you have. So make sure you know your base clock, because that's the speed we're gonna be running it at. And then we're gonna be dropping the voltages until it's stable. All right, so here we are inside of the BIOS of the 9950 X3D. So the first thing you're gonna do with any CPU, so in this case, I know it is 4.3 gigahertz. And the 9950 X3D is the first X3D chip where you can actually set your manual voltages and clock. So in this case, this setup here is gonna be exactly like if you're setting up a 3900X, 5900X, 3950X, you know, anything other than an X3D. So the first thing we always do is we come down, we go to XMP Expo Profile, and we just enable that. You might have an Expo here, depending on your RAM, it'll say either XMP or Expo. It is recommended if you do have RAM that supports Expo to use Expo, but if it only supports XMP, use XMP1 in this case, which I have right there. So that's the first thing you are going to do in this. And XMP is more of an Intel thing, but it works just fine on Ryzen as well. So next up here, like I mentioned, AM5, it has a special high bandwidth support. So on AM5 platform, 7 and 9000 series CPU, you're gonna wanna enable high bandwidth. So enable it that way. Now going back here one second, cause some of you guys may have like an Asus motherboard or something. I believe when it comes to your XMP profiles, you're gonna have to know the speed of your RAM. In this case, it's 6000. So you might have to manually set it to that number 6000. So keep that in mind, depending on the motherboard brand, things can be a little bit different, but usually you just turn on XMP or you select the speed of the RAM that you got. All right, so the next thing we're going to do, we're going to come up and we're going to look for CPU clock ratio. We're going to click on that, and now we're going to adjust it to that 4.3. Now, depending on your motherboard brand and how they put it, look for something that says 4300, 43.00 in this case is what mine is right there, but something depending, sometimes it by 10, sometimes it by 100, and sometimes it by 1000. But here we go, 43.00 is 4.3 gigahertz, and that is our base clock speed. Now in this case, we're gonna go down to our CPU vCore. We're gonna enter that, and now we're gonna start dropping voltages. So I like to start somewhere, you know, depending on silicon lottery, this is where factors will really determine how well you can undervolt and the most efficiency you can get out of it. 1 volt, you shouldn't have to go over that. I do have a few 3900Xs that in the past I did have to run over 1 volt to remain stable. But usually you try to start with something like 0.97, is like 975 or something. Enable this, hit F10, that will save all your settings. And then you're gonna go and mine something like Random X or something for 10 to 15 minutes and see if you're stable. If you are, you're gonna come back into here and drop it a little bit more. And then hit F10 again,
go and mine for 10, 15 minutes on random X, and then come back with stable and keep going down until it finally crashes, either when it first boots up and it crashes, or maybe it takes about 5 minutes and then it crashes. That means you're hitting the unstable. It needs a little bit more voltage. Once you hit that stage, so you might be down to even like, you know, 9.25 here, just bring it up maybe 9.3, 9.35, one or two notches, save it there, and then let it run for a full day and see if it's stable or not. If it's stable, you're good. If it's not, you might have to bring it up one more and then you're good to go. So that's basic overclocking when it comes to just setting your core, setting your XMP profile, and then setting your voltage speeds to make it nice and stable at the lowest voltage possible. And remember, depending on silicon lottery, you might have to use, you won't get as low is some other CPUs. All right, so that's basic tuning when it comes to your standard 3900X, 7950X, you know, your X series type of Ryzen CPUs. Now, if you have an X3D, you gotta do things a little bit different unless it's a 9000 series X3D, which we can set the voltages and the core individually. But for the other X3Ds, we gotta run PBO. And you can run PBO also on the standard X series and run a little bit more efficient, but I just like to set my cores and everything basically on those. But this same setup here will also work on all the Ryzen CPUs if you want to use PBO. So the first thing we do got to do is obviously everything's on auto. We don't have any of our CPU clock ratios. It's all on auto. So the first thing we always do is come into here, exact same thing, enable your XMP profile. So come into here, enable XMP or Expo, whichever one it says for yours. Expo is recommended if you do have Expo on your Ryzens other than XMP. But other than that, choose anyone and they both work here. Make sure you do enable high bandwidth support, enable right there. Disable, you know, disabled is by default, but enabling it will increase your hash rate on RandomX and memory dependent algorithms here. So once you're done that, you're pretty much done in this tab. Next, we're going to do is we're going to come into our settings here and we're going to go to AMD overclocking. We're going to enter that, we're going to accept that, and we're going to scroll on down to precision boost overdrive. So we're clicking here, and now we're going to go into our curve optimizer, which is this guy right here. And now you can see we're going to set this to a negative. So by default, I can't remember, I think it says positive. So just click on it and make sure you say negative. And that is all core curve optimizer sign. So negative curve, which means it's pushing the voltages down. It's also increasing your clock speed. I know that's weird, huh? It's doing both at the same time, because the lower you go, the higher the hash rate you get. And it's also the less power you're consuming. So it's kind of dropping voltages and overclocking it at the same time. So it's pretty cool what happens there. And then when it comes to this is your magic setting here, which is like setting your voltages in the other way, your curve optimizer magnitude here is setting, you know, your stability on the lowest core. Obviously in this one, I can go all the way down to 60, but you know, it starts off at zero. So start with something like, you know, maybe 20. Oh, we get rid of that. Let's just go back here. So start at something like maybe 20. Do your testing again, hit F10 and save this, see if it's stable or not. Come back, you know, maybe try 25, see if that's stable or not. Maybe try 30, see if that's stable or not. And keep doing that for your 10, 15 minute tests here and see just how well that goes. For this one, in this case, it does work upwards to 60, which is the max. You can't go any more below that in terms of this. Now, one more other thing you want to do, because you are still going to be using quite a bit of power, you got to turn on eco mode. Now, you don't have to use eco mode. If you have cheap power or something, you can run it without it, but you're going to need definitely better coolers and stuff because it's going to run a lot hotter. But eco mode, it's a simple setting. You just come back here, come in, get out of here, all this stuff. Now we're going to go to AMD CBS. We're going to come on down to, where is that CMU or UMC? Nope. SMU right here, and we're going to find eco mode, and then we're just going to enable that right there. Eco mode is now enabled. Hit F10, and this is going to drop your TDP down, I think, to the 65 watt one. You're still going to be using, based when you get it set out, it's around 130 to 135 watts on Random X, which is Monero and the current Tari. So by enabling that eco mode, whatever you can get this number, the all core curve optimizer 2, as low as you can get it by running stable, this will increase your hash rate and keep your power consumption nice and low based on that. So that is basic overclocking or undervolting or setting up your CPU mining rigs for mining. Now you're probably wondering why choose random X stuff. There is one other algorithm that is more intensive than random X, but I like to use random X. There's only like one or two coins ever on that other one, and then they're usually dead in 2 days and I never mine them anyway. But you know, the point here is random X is one of the most intensive algorithms. So once you're stable on that, you can move over to any of the other CPU mineable coins, minus the one I kind of just mentioned. I can't remember the name of it off the top of my head. Let me know in the comments if you know, but you can, won't go down. So if you tweak for something like, let's say you go to Kyla coin or something, and then you move to random X, you're going to have your rigs go down on you all the time. And it's going to be a pain to go into the BIOS on them all and keep setting them up. That's why you tweak for the one of the hardest algorithms out there. That way, when you're stable, you don't have to worry about switching coins later on. So hopefully this video helps you out in a nice, easy way to get your CPU rigs running nice and stable. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.